What is up, YouTube? I want to give a shout out to Alter Wise and Little John King. They've been longtime supporters, so thanks for the support. And I was scrolling through Facebook when I saw something, an article that was posted regarding the drug war in Saudi Arabia. Four brothers were arrested for an undisclosed amount of hashish, and as punishment for being caught with the said undisclosed amount of hashish, freaking, they were beheaded on the capital city. And you know what I'm saying? And it's just ridiculous. This drug war is it's just unfortunate when it exceeds the drug war. It is ridiculous. It's beyond ridiculous. That's what I did here. Fuck me. Why? I spelled sorrow wrong. God damn it. So now I gotta go to my fucking iTunes. Oh, I have it spelled correctly on here. Let's see. Maybe I have it spelled incorrectly on my YouTube. Hold on a second. I spelled it correctly, never mind. Oh wait, hold on. Someone asks if I wear diapers, and I go, no, I don't wear diapers. That's fucking stupid. You want proof? Oh, look. My decorative skull underwear. No, okay, I don't wear diapers, YouTube. Boxers or briefs. People gotta try so fucking hard to mess with me. And it's just, it's getting old. Catching up on my comment section a little bit here. But yeah, could you imagine, you know, the drug laws in some countries are so someone hit me up on YouTube and they're like, you should actually sing the rest of Blue Suede Shoes. Yeah, suppose I could, but not right now, obviously.
What's up, YouTube?
What's up, YouTube? People posting or making GIFs about me on fucking YouTube and shit. But yeah, freaking, you know, when people try messing with me on YouTube, I don't want to get to me too much because I realize that there are bigger issues and people going through more shit. You know what I'm saying? Wow. But what people won't do to try to mess with me on the freaking internet. You know what I'm saying? It's just ridiculous. But, you know. You have to learn to somehow kind of get used to it, because if you don't, then, you know, these monsters on this website will eat you alive, YouTube. Off topic completely. Yeah, going back to what I read this on Facebook. 4 men getting beheaded for an undisclosed amount of hashish. Really? You know, I'm not trying to sound racist or nothing, YouTube, but you think the Saudi Arabian police would have bigger issues to deal with? You know, like beheading ISIS members in the town square versus beheading somebody for using a little bit of hashish. I'm all in favor of worldwide, I do say this, worldwide legalization of cannabis and hemp. You know, this, I'm just grateful that drug laws in this country that I live in aren't that severe, you know. I mean, it's pretty shitty that if you get caught with one marijuana cigarette in the United States, you know what I'm saying, you can't get a housing loan or a student loan or any of that shit. But in some countries of this world, you get caught with some marijuana-like shit, and then they take it upon themselves to behead you in front of everybody. And it's just, it's ridiculous, YouTube, it really is. Now, someone asked if my apartment smelled like stale tobacco, and not necessarily, because every so often, you know, I crack a window to minimize the smell, you know what I'm saying? And, unfortunately, that's just the nature of certain laws. Yeah. A friend of mine stopped by earlier, a couple friends of mine stopped by earlier, and they hooked me up with some cigarettes. That's what's up, YouTube. Now, I could not begin to imagine drug laws being so ridiculously harsh that you get caught with any marijuana and they just behead you. Like, really? It's bad enough when they're arresting Iraq or any war veteran for smoking it for their PTSD. Yeah, it is truly disgusting when they do shit like that. But to full out just behead somebody because it's against your laws or whatever, you know. I'm just grateful that, you know, we don't have laws like that in place. Grateful that we don't have laws that say that, you know, hypothetical. Let's just say that if a cop caught you with some weed, that the law was they had to drag you out into the middle of the city or town you lived in front of everybody, and put a bullet in the back of your fucking skull just for smoking it. Now, thankfully, we don't have laws like that in place. But, you know what I'm saying? And you know, if Saudi Arabia wants to behead ISIS members, child molesters, and rapists, and what have you, then yeah, I'm all for it, you know what I'm saying? But you're gonna behead somebody for a little bit of fucking hash oil. Four brothers who did nothing more than break a ridiculous drug law. And what's sad is that, you know, if every country and every city and every state on this entire planet legalized pot and hemp for industrial growth, the world would be a better place. There would be less fucking violence and less fucking wars. To sit there and deny about marijuana and its amazing economic and medical benefits that it has, to deny those exist, is blatant ignorance. I was in complete shock when I saw the story on Facebook. Four brothers beheaded for an undisclosed amount of hashish. I mean, really? At what point does this drug war become too much? Do I feel disgusting just knowing that Casper, Wyoming is the meth capital of the United States of America? Yeah, unfortunately, it is pretty disgusting. You know, they legalized pot and hemp out here, especially. It'd make Wyoming even more rich than it already is. If they got rid of all that nasty meth in this community, especially, you know, it'd make the community a much better place. But outside of that, if you want to make a community a better place to live, then it's a group effort, YouTube. You know, I hear friends of mine on Facebook bitching about where they live. You know what I'm saying? I hear people on Facebook bitch about where they live, and it could be worse, mind you. And if you want to make the place you live a better place to live, then that's a group effort that requires everybody in the community to do their part. You know what I'm saying? And the first step to building a better community is less fucking drama. It's ridiculous. I mean, the drama bullshit, it's annoying as fuck when you're in high school, but sometimes, unfortunately, as young adults, some people like to start drama for whatever fucking reason, because they like seeing their adult friends go through some kind of shit. And how could you call somebody your friend if you're trying to start drama with the group you're in? In all honesty, though. And no one knows how exactly they got busted. It could have been the four brothers just smoking some hashish out of a hookah or something, and then the Saudi Arabian police came in and busted him. And it's just, it's stupid YouTube. There have been plenty of examples of unfair, uncivilized justice regarding the drug war here in the United States alone. War veterans coming home to their children and their family, fighting for their country and our liberties and our freedom, decide they want to smoke pot for their PTSD. But just because it's illegal in the state they live in, the state has to arrest them and take them away from their loved ones and family members just because of a stupid fucking drug war. And it's enough to make my skin crawl, YouTube. It really is. Now, if you wanna just stop with me for a second and imagine how a soldier could possibly get PTSD for fighting a war for this country, especially if they have kids of their own. If their platoon leader says, and I quote, "That child is a danger to your squad, and you have to kill them to fight for your country." So they have to unknowingly shoot someone else's kid to protect the freedom of their own country. And when you're fighting a war overseas and you run into something like that, especially if you have kids of your own, I can't imagine, man. I cannot possibly even begin to imagine what that could do to someone's psyche. And of all fucking people, you're gonna deny the right of medical marijuana to our own veterans, really? Slowly but surely, marijuana is getting legalized all over the country, state by state. So even if your state isn't legal on pot yet, it will be soon enough. In the meantime, cops in these cities and states where pot is illegal could focus on other things, catching meth heads, catching rapists and child molesters and people of that nature. Because when you think about it, in all honesty, YouTube, these are the people doing real damage to society. Some long-haired hippie smoking that wacky tobacco. Ooh, yeah. Sounds like a real fucking menace to society, doesn't it? No, not really. Not really, no. Now, despite the medical and economic benefits of marijuana, what would drive a cop to arrest somebody for pot use? Other than it's against the law in some cities and states. And there's a very simple answer to that question, YouTube. The DEA pays cops 5% of drug bust money to keep pot illegal in certain cities and states. And when they do this, cops gotta make their quota and shit. So if they suspect somebody has spoken some ganji, you know. One of my friends got popped with a glass piece the other day. And the fucked up thing of it is the cop stopped him and said that he smelled pot. And automatically your rights are fucked if the cop says that, whether or not you smell like it or not. You know what I'm saying? And the friend of mine didn't even smell like it, you know what I'm saying? And the cop searches him and finds his glass pot pipe that he had on him that his friend had given to him before his friend had passed away. And he lost that because of this, you know, bullshit with Wyoming's drug laws. And he was in the jail for about maybe 20 minutes at the most before he was released and put on unsupervised probation, which means they could piss test you at any given time. Whereas supervised probation, they tell you when exactly they're going to piss test you, you know what I'm saying? And the people in the jail, a very common thing people ask you when you go to jail is, what are you in for? Okay? So my friend gets out and he was telling me when people are asking him what he was in there for, and he told him it was for a pot pipe, everybody in the jail he went to said that was stupid. That was fucking ridiculous. Now, when you take a look at areas of the country where people are losing their fucking jobs, where the economy sucks so goddamn bad, it's not even funny, it's just fucking sad. You know what I'm saying? When the economy sucks, people are losing their jobs, and people are having a hard time providing for their families and their kin. And you want to fucking tell me you're going to keep pot illegal? When you look at the history of Colorado since marijuana legalization, all the jobs it's opened up for people, all the tourism it's created, all the money it's generating for your state. And the thing of it is, YouTube, if pot were completely legal across the entire United States, that could be money that's going into our economy. On the for real, though. I mean, it's not rocket science, it's just common fucking sense. Okay? Now, my argument for marijuana legalization on my channel, I'm sure it sounds like a broken record to a lot of people. But when I see stories like this pop up, not just in the United States, but all over the world in general, the whole thing just makes me sick to my stomach. Now, for the sake of the video, we're going to do a little bit of math. We're going to go to Google and do a little bit of research. How much money does Colorado make off of weed? Let's see. CNN Money. Recreational pot makes Colorado $53 billion in tax revenue. Oh, ha 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 ha. 53, not billion, excuse me, million, but still. $53 million in tax revenue. Stupid internet ad, go away. Another website claims Colorado collected almost $70 million in marijuana taxes during the past year or so. Another website claims $76 million. Okay, so rough estimate of $70 million in tax revenue in just 1 year. Okay, so if we take let's say there's there's 51 states in the United States of America times 70, which will tell us how much money we could possibly make in tax revenue. Okay. We'll take a rough estimate about 70 million. And calculator. Take 51 states times, what's your 70? Okay, equals. Holy shit! 3,570 million dollars in tax revenue. If you take the 70 million and multiply that number by the number of states in this country, if there's 51 states in the United States of America, that means 3,570 million dollars in tax revenue. Okay, so if marijuana would have been legal throughout the entire United States, the very second Colorado legalized it for recreational and medical use, that means the country, the United States of America, right now, would have been making $3,570 million in tax revenue. Holy shit. That doesn't include recreational sales. Now, if you're trying to convince Republicans in your state to legalize it or to consider it, money talks, bullshit walks. You know what I'm saying? And that's just in tax revenue, YouTube. That doesn't include recreational sales. Four men beheaded in the Middle East for what? You heard right. A little bit of fucking hash oil or hashish. Hashtag fuck this drug war.